I am Mr. Praveen Yellappa Kumbar. Today we want to see numericals on orbital parameters. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of the session, student will be able to illustrate the concept of the orbital parameters. The contents of these topics are, here we want to see two. Now the first problem is, a satellite is orbiting in an elliptical orbit with apogee height at a 20,000 km and the perigee height at a 400 km. So we want to calculate here the ratio of velocity at perigee to that of apogee will be. So before solving this problem, first of all we want to try to understand the concept of apogee and the perigee. So basically what will happen, my friends, this is a Earth. Suppose this is a Earth that I want to write. This is a Earth and satellite is orbiting. The satellite is orbiting in a elliptical orbit. Satellite is orbiting in an elliptical orbit. Suppose the satellite is at a point here. So this is a satellite. Now this we called as a satellite. Now my friends, the perigee and apogee. The perigee means nearest distance. So if in this diagram, if you observe, the perigee is this one. This one is called as a perigee. The perigee means what? Nearest distance. And the apogee will be the farthest distance, longest distance. That is called as apogee. This is called as apogee and this is called as a perigee. So now for solving this type of a problem, first of all you write down given data. So what is the given data? The apogee height. So I will write given data here. Given data. So I will write here given data. That is what? The first of all, the apogee height. What is the apogee height? Apogee height is equal to 20,000 kilometer. And what is the perigee height? Perigee height will be 400 kilometer. And what we find out? The ratio of velocity at perigee to that of velocity at apogee. So I will find out this one. So first of all, you calculate the velocity of perigee, then you calculate the velocity of apogee and take the ratio of that one, then you get the answer of velocity at perigee and the velocity of apogee. So before solving this type of a problem, you know the what is the radius of the Earth. So the radius of the Earth is, so radius of Earth is equal to 6378 kilometer. That we want to know these things. This is we know radius of the Earth is 6378 kilometer. So after that one, I want to calculate, I want to write down distance of apogee, distance of apogee from, I want to calculate now distance of apogee from where? From the center of the Earth. From the center of the Earth. So I want to calculate now distance of apogee from center of Earth. So what will come that one? That is called as apogee, that is distance that we treated as RA. So how we calculate? So we made the addition of 6. This is a radius of the Earth is what? Radius of the Earth is 6378. Plus, what is the apogee height? 20,000. So what we get? 6378 plus 20,000, we get 26,378 kilometer. Okay, so we get the distance of apogee from the center of the Earth. Now after that one, we calculate the same distance of perigee. Distance of perigee from where? From, again we calculate from center of Earth. From the center of Earth. So distance of perigee I treated as that is RP. So what we get, 6378 is the radius of the earth plus 400 kilometer. So what we get, 6378 plus 400, we get 6778 kilometer. So this is the distance of perigee from the center of the earth. Now after that one, so what is our, we want to calculate velocity of perigee and velocity of apogee. So what is the formula of so before that one, we want to calculate the semi-major axis. So semi-major axis is equal to distance of apogee from the center of earth, that is we call as RA, plus distance of perigee from the center of earth, that is RP, divided by 2. So we want to put the value of RA and RP into this equation, that is 26,378 plus what is RP, that is 6778 divided by 2. So after the solving this one, you get, so after the addition you get 33,156 divided by 2. So after solving you get 16578 kilometer. 16578 kilometer is velocity at perigee to the velocity of apogee. So I want to write here velocity of perigee divided by velocity at apogee. So what is the formula for that one? The formula is, so I will write velocity at VP divided by velocity at VA. So what is the formula? The formula is 2 by RP minus 1 by R divided by, so I will write here for this one again, 2 by RA divided minus 1 by R. This is the formula for the velocity of perigee and velocity of apogee. So now we want to put the values into this equation. So what we get, so we know that RP means what, my friends? RP means perigee from the center of the earth. RA is a what? The apogee from the center of the earth. That we know, the put the values there. And R means semi-major axis. So the simply, we want to put these values into this equation. What we get? Well, first of all, we calculate the VP. So what is a VP? VP is under square root of 2 divided by RP minus 1 by R. So we put the values. What is the RP? RP is a 2 divided by 6778 minus 1 by R. 1 by R means what? 1 by 16578. So after the solving this equation, we get 2.34 into 10 raised to minus 4. 2.34 into 10 raised to minus 4 after solving this gate. So after the square root of this one, we get 0.01532 is the VP, that is velocity at the perigee. The same we want to calculate for the velocity at the apogee. So I will write down, this is equation number 1. I want to calculate the velocity that is at VA. So for the VA, what is the formula? The formula is 2 by RA minus 1 by R. So we want to put these values into this above equation. What do we get? We get 2 by, what is the RA? RA is a 26,378 minus 1 by R. What is the R? That we know, 16578. So after you want to solve this one. So after the solving this one, we get 1.54 into 10 raised to minus 5. The square root of this one, we get 3.93 into 10 raised to minus 3. Okay, this is a what? VA. This is a what? VA. So this is a equation number 2. What will come? Therefore, I want to write velocity of perigee divided by velocity at apogee. So put the equation number 1 and 2 here. What we get? So zero velocity at perigee, what? 0.01532 divided by 3.93 into 10 raised to minus 3. So after this solving this one, we get 3.89. So answer is what? 3.89. So the ratio of the velocity at perigee to that apogee will be 3.89. So this will be the answer. This will be. Now we want to consider the second problem. The second problem is the difference between the farthest and closest point in a satellite elliptical orbit from the surface of the Earth is 30,000 km and sum of distance is 50,000 km. If the mean radius of the Earth is considered to be 6,400 km, determine the eccentricity and the length of the semi-major axis of the orbit. So here I want to write down first given data from this example. G minus perigee equal to 30,000. Why? Because when we made a subtraction between this apogee and the perigee, what will happen? Due to the subtraction, the radius of each is cancelled. The radius is cancelled in the subtraction. Therefore, this apogee minus perigee is 30,000. So this is a given point first. Now second point, I want to calculate the apogee plus perigee. So for that, apogee plus perigee is equal to, there is a formula, we want to put that formula. So after that, putting the formula, what we get? 50,000 plus 2 into 6,400 kilometer. Okay, so after the putting these values and after solving this, what we get? We get 62,800 kilometer. Now we want to calculate what? I want to calculate. So what we want to calculate? We want to calculate eccentricity. We want to calculate the eccentricity. And the second thing I want to calculate, the length of the semi-major axis. The length of the semi-major axis. So I want to calculate. So what is the formula for the eccentricity? So eccentricity is equal to apogee minus perigee divided by apogee plus perigee. So apogee plus perigee. So this is a formula. We want to put these values into this above equation, what we get? 30,000 divided by 62,800. So after the division of these things, we get 0.47 is the eccentricity. 0.47 is the eccentricity of this equation. So now I want to calculate what? Now I want to calculate the semi-major axis. So for the calculation of a semi-major axis, so we know that in the previous problem, we solved that the semi-major axis is equal to apogee plus perigee divided by 2. So I want to write semi-major axis is equal to apogee plus perigee divided by 2. So we want to put these values into this equation. So what we get? Apogee plus perigee, that is, we want to calculate here apogee plus perigee is what? 62,800 divided by 2. So after this solving this one, what we get? 31,400 kilometer. The references for this topic is, thank you.